name's Sarah Willingham, and I know exactly how to help you boost your bank balance and put some weight in your wallet. I am tired of listening to loud, in-your-face jargon. I'm going to keep it clear and simple and help you save some serious cash. See, look at this. I've just walked through the door and already they're tempting me with an impulse buy. Lovely, soft lemon muffins. Are they on the list? No, put them back. This is another example of very clever retailing. These end-of-aisle offers are not always the best offers in store. This is the most expensive place for brands to put their products. Somebody has got to pay for that, and don't let it be you. I found an absolute gem of a website, mysupermarket.co.uk. You go onto this website. I'm actually going to do a little demonstration. This website's great. You do your normal shop, and it compares across the major supermarkets how to get your cheapest basket.
This is just brilliant. Amazing.
You'll love this.
Does it order it for you?
You can then go to. You can then choose your basket, whichever one's the cheapest, the one you prefer, and it will instantly go through to that website, and you'll do your shop.
So,
it's great.
This is a genius.
You wait
website.
For this. So this, for example, I've already done my shopping. Here it is. So I go onto this cheese, and it says I've got, there's a little pound sign here, and it says swap and save. So I click on that, but it gives me the different options of similar products, but that are on offer in that particular store or across the stores that are just cheaper. Do you think that it is realistic to open a restaurant with 90% of your products sourced locally? I think on the one opportunity they've got to blow us away with their signature disc, and all they've done is opened a few packets. I'm absolutely flabbergasted. They could think they've done well when they haven't even served a quarter of the people out there. I'm in shock. It's not all doom and gloom. I walk away from today thinking, actually, there's some of those couples with some real potential there. So before we get going on the real thing, the holiday, what I wanted to do is test your negotiation skills first. And I found a gem of a sweetie shop called A Quarter of Sweets. Now what I want you to do is go inside there, I'm going to give you some money, and I want you to come back out with the cheapest 3 kilograms of sweets that you can buy. Yeah, so you went in with the idea of getting a variety of different sweets.
Yeah.
And she said to you, you can't do that. That'll cost you 30 quid.
Yeah.
But if you buy one, it's £22.
Yeah.
So straight away, she's immediately flagging to you that if you buy a lot of one thing, you've got an instant discount. I agree with everything you've just said, but I honestly, inside, I feel that that wasn't with the benefit of foresight, that was all with the benefit of hindsight. I think you're winging it, honestly. And I think at the time, afterwards you went, oh my God, I've just given away 20% of everything. I went, oh, please God, let it work. Please let it work. And it paid off. And now you can give us this brilliant speech. And we're dead proud you did really well. You're so shrewd. What a great location. This is prime for a bed and breakfast. But I'm standing here and straight away I can see that there are lots of bed and breakfasts around here.
First impressions are good.
That is what you want to have your coffee and sit and look out at,
isn't
it?
That's what we thought, yeah.
Blimey. When you say you've had plumbing problems, you weren't exaggerating.
No, the whole house, isn't it?
Did you do surveys?
I've never known a survey actually do anything other than a guy comes in, kicks the wall and says, yeah, it's fine, where's my 300 quid?
It would have saved you a lot of money. Are you going for a star grading here?
I've been so focused on the fabric of the house, I just really haven't had the time.
I'm amazed that you don't. That's one of the first things to find the answers to. There's no point getting the house ready if you don't know what you're getting it ready for. Mm. Can you imagine how much money you'll end up wasting if you go down a particular path thinking that you're doing the right thing and in fact it only gets you a 2-star and you wanted a 4-star? For example, if you want a 4-star, those blinds won't do.
Right.
You know, they've got to be black out. You can't have somebody waking up to brilliant sunlight in the morning. There are many online sites where you can sell your unwanted items. I'm going to use eBay. We're going to start by setting up an account. So most sites are going to charge you between 5 or 10% commission, but make sure you check out the fees before you start.
And we have that amount now. Here's how much she made. £332.
Isn't that amazing?
In 2 hours' work.
You know, everybody freaks out when you start talking about selling stuff on the internet because they think it's so complicated. I mean, look, you know, eBay have done some research. They reckon everybody has got around £450.
Yeah.
You got your deal, girls. Yay! You got your deal.
Amsterdam.
Yay! I'm so chuffed for them. It is absolutely amazing. What a bargain. It just goes to show that when you bring a few people together, you can negotiate and make such a difference to the prize. I cannot wait to see what we do next. It's